Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss amplitude, period, midline, and graph of general form of trigonometric functions involving transformation. Now, in our earlier session, we had discussed about the period, amplitude, and midline. Now, in this session, we will discuss the general form of trigonometric function, that is y is equal to a sine of b into x minus c the whole plus k, or y is equal to a cos of b into x minus c the whole plus k. Now in our earlier sessions, we have also discussed the graph of trigonometric functions. We saw the graph of trigonometric functions is periodic. We have also discussed that a of f of x, f of ax, f of x plus a, and f of x plus a the whole are all transformations of the function f of x, and each of these transformation can be applied to sine and cosine functions. Now in order to write the periodic function, we will make use of transformation of sine and cosine functions. Now equation of periodic function involving trigonometric functions can be of the following type. First type is y is equal to a sine of bx, or y is equal to a cos of bx. Second one is y is equal to a sine of b into x minus c the whole, or y is equal to a cos of b into x minus c the whole. And the next type is y is equal to a sine of b into x minus c the whole plus k, or y is equal to a cos of b into x minus c the whole plus k. Now for the functions y is equal to a sine of bx and y is equal to a cos of bx, amplitude is given by absolute value of a, period is given by 2 pi upon absolute value of b, or 360 degrees upon absolute value of b. For example, if we have a function y is equal to minus 6 cos of 3x. Now here a is minus 6 and b is 3. So here amplitude will be equal to absolute value of minus 6, which is equal to 6. And period is equal to 2 pi upon absolute value of 3, which is 3. Now let us discuss what is a phase shift. Now the functions y is equal to a sine of b into x minus c the whole, and y is equal to a cos of b into x minus c the whole, refers to phase shift of length c to the right or left horizontally. Now the curve is shifted to the right if c is greater than 0, and the curve is shifted to the left if c is less than 0. Now here you can see we have taken the graph of y is equal to a sine of bx, that is this curve, and here you can see when we shift the graph by length c, where c is greater than 0, and we are shifting this graph horizontally to the right we get this green curve and the equation of this curve is y is equal to a sine of b into x minus c the whole. And now when we shift the curve, that is this pink curve, by the length c, and here c is less than 0, so here we are shifting this pink curve by length c horizontally to the left, and we are getting this blue curve. So here equation of this blue curve will be y is equal to a sine of b into x plus c the whole, as here c is less than 0. Similarly, here we have taken this graph, and here the equation of this pink curve is y is equal to a cos of bx, and when we are shifting this graph by length c horizontally to the right, then we are getting this green curve, and equation of this curve is y is equal to a cos of b into x minus c the whole. And when we shift this pink curve by length c horizontally to the left, then we get this blue curve, and equation of this blue curve is y is equal to a cos of b into x plus c the whole. Now let us discuss an example. Here we are given y is equal to 2 sine of x plus pi by 4 the whole. Now here a is 2, b is 1, so here amplitude will be equal to absolute value of a, which is equal to absolute value of 2, that is equal to 2, and period is equal to 2 pi upon absolute value of b, that is absolute value of 1, and this is equal to 2 pi upon 1, which is equal to 2 pi. Now we know that phase shift is given by c, and here we can write x plus pi by 4 as x minus of minus pi by 4. So here c is equal to minus pi by 4. This means here c is less than 0. Therefore, the curve is shifted to the left as c is less than 0. Now let us discuss what is a vertical shift. Now graph of trigonometric functions can be translated horizontally through a phase shift, and they can be translated vertically through a vertical shift. Now in a trigonometric function, let it be y is equal to sine x, if any constant is added, then the graph is shifted upwards or downwards. For example, y is equal to sine x plus k. Now here, k is greater than 0 and k is a constant which is added to sine x function. So the graph shifts upwards. Now if we have y is equal to sine x minus k, then the graph shifts downwards. Now the midline changes when there is a vertical shift. Now for upward shift, New midline is given by y is equal to k, and for downward shift, new midline is given by y is equal to minus k. Now here we can see the graph of the trigonometric function y is equal to sin x. Now for this trigonometric function, the midline is given by y is equal to 0, that is the x-axis, as we know that midline is the line about which the function oscillates above and below equally. And now we have drawn another curve, that is this green curve whose equation is y is equal to sin x plus k, and the new midline, that is the midline of this green curve, is given by y is equal to k. So here you can see that the curve with equation y is equal to sin x is shifted upwards, and we have obtained a new curve, that is this green curve with equation y is equal to sin x plus k. So this is the curve with vertical shift, and this is the curve without vertical shift. And similar rule holds for cosine function. Now in general we have y is equal to a sine of b into x minus c the whole plus k, and y is equal to a cos of b into x minus c the whole plus k. So here midline is given by y is equal to k. Now here the curve shifts upwards for k greater than 0 and curve shifts downwards for k less than 0. Now let us see an example. Here consider a function y is equal to 4 cos of 1 by 2 into theta minus pi by 3 the whole minus 6. Now let us find the vertical shift, amplitude, period and phase shift of this function. For finding this, let us compare this function with y is equal to a cos of b into x minus c the whole plus k. Comparing, here we have a is equal to 4, b is equal to 1 by 2, c is equal to pi by 3 and k is equal to minus 6. So, amplitude is equal to absolute value of a, that is absolute value of 4, which is equal to 4. Period is equal to 2 pi upon absolute value of b, that is absolute value of 1 by 2. This is equal to 2 pi upon 1 by 2, which is equal to 4 pi. Now we know that vertical shift is given by y is equal to k. Now here, as k is minus 6, so the curve shifts downwards, and here midline is given by y is equal to minus 6. Now phase shift is given by the value of c, and here as c is pi by 3, so here phase shift is equal to pi by 3. And here as c is greater than 0, so the curve is shifted to the right by pi by 3. Now we can draw the graph of the function, and here we draw number line with angles in radians on horizontal axis and number line on vertical axis. Now here midline is given by y is equal to minus 6. So we have drawn a horizontal line at y is equal to minus 6. Now period is equal to 4 pi. It means one cycle completes in 4 pi. After this point, curve repeats and the graph is stretched till 4 pi. Now amplitude is equal to 4. So the curve reaches maximum and minimum height at a distance of 4 units from midline. So we take 4 units above, y is equal to minus 6, and we get y is equal to minus 2 as the maximum point. And we take 4 units below, y is equal to minus 6, and we get the minimum point at y is equal to minus 10. And here we have drawn dotted lines at y is equal to minus 2 and at y is equal to minus 10. Now here, first of all, we will draw the graph of y is equal to 4 cos of 1 by 2 into theta minus 6 without phase shift. So graph starts on y axis in the wave pattern at y is equal to minus 2, and from that point graph moves downwards according to midline and reaches minimum height. Then it returns back to the maximum point and completes one cycle. So this is the graph of the function y is equal to 4 cos of 1 by 2 into theta minus 6. Now we have phase shift of pi by 3. So we shift the curve to the right by pi by 3, and we get this graph, and this is the graph of the function y is equal to 4 cos of 1 by 2 into theta minus pi by 3 the whole minus 6. And here, if there was no vertical shift given, then the midline would have been x-axis, that is y is equal to 0. So in this session we have learnt amplitude, period, midline and graph of general form of trigonometric function involving transformation. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.